What is going on? We are back in the world of Dragon Ball Z Dokkan Battle. Now, recently, on the Japanese version of the game, there was a celebration to celebrate the 5 long years that this game has existed. Now, I don't know what's crazier, the fact that a mobile game survived for 5 years, or that I've been playing it for 5 years. And by amazing, I mean sad. But I digress. In these 5 long years, a lot has happened in the game. The game has evolved over time. Instead of just popping bubbles, now you're popping bubbles in an optimized way. And I gotta say that, you know, as time moves on, just like in history, just like in this game's history, there's some people who get forgotten. There's some people who get left behind. There's some people who don't get their just dues. And that is what this video is about. It is about the individuals, the SSRs that were forgotten. They never got an awakening. I'm not talking about a Dokkan special awakening or... Well, actually, I am talking about Dokkan awakening. But I'm not talking about an Extreme Z awakening. I'm not talking about a super duper double Dokkan awakening. I'm just talking about a rebirth or a Dokkan awakening. Something. Give these people something. Give them Shafting the Limit or Fierce Battle. Anything. Now, I will start off with units on this list that, as we go closer to number one, you're going to feel the disrespect even more. But starting off right now, I got to say, Super Saiyan 3, Tech Vegeta. Now, with this slot, I would also include Phi Vegeta, the Phi Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. They're very similar in the sense that they're both pretty damn good. They're both pretty decent. They could be a lot better if they got a Dokkan Awakening and got, you know, thrown into some more categories or got a little bit more love. But me personally, my biggest gripe is with the Super Saiyan 3 Vegeta. This man's name is Into the Fierce Battle. How are you going to have Into the Fierce Battle in your name, but then you look at the link list and there's no Fierce Battle? Now, that's me personally. I take that as a fuck you from Bandai. They're just basically saying, like, LOL, look at you, stupid ass. Very disrespectful. I don't appreciate that, Bandai. And again, both units are pretty cool. Me personally, I like the tech one more than the Phi one. Attack and defense plus 70%. Plus an additional attack plus 60% for 5 turns after receiving attack. That's not that bad, dude. 130% attack ain't bad for a base SSR unit. This guy could be way better with a Dokkan Awakening. And I don't know when or if it's going to happen. I'm kind of hoping it happens within like the next year, maybe. Because this card came out in like 2018. So it's been like almost 2 years. It's like, dude, where's this man's fucking justice? Like, can he get something other than those tight pants to look forward to in life? Like, it's fucking depressing. Now, the next entry on this list is, you know, this is kind of a theme of this, is that he is the first of many. And now, when I say the first of many, I'm talking about Super Saiyan 2, Int Gohan Youth. Now, he was the first Baba Shop SSR. He was probably the most hype Baba Shop SSR for me personally. When he came out, I was like, oh my god, this guy's a fucking god. Attack plus 77%. When HP is 80% or below, wow, what? Holy shit. Now, this guy never got a Dokkan Awakening. Like, I thought, like, I was for sure thinking, I'm like, dude, this guy, you know, he's the first Baba Shop SSR. Other Baba Shop SSRs got Dokkan Awakenings eventually. Like, this guy's definitely going to get it. But it's been forever, and this man is getting no love. Like, you would think at this point, he'd already have a shitty Dokkan Awakening. Maybe get an easy A or something. But this dude is just left in the past. No one cares about him. Me personally, I'm depressed because I thought he was going to awaken into like a Super Omega badass card. But not much has happened with him. And pretty much everything has passed him by. And now, like, I don't know how you would even run this guy. He has no defensive buff. His passive is ass, 80% or below. What the fuck is this? What are you, a Vegeta card? So me personally, it's depressing. It's sad to see it. You hate to see it happen. But this Gohan really needs a Dokkan Awakening, and he needs, like, a fucking makeover, because this dude is, like, really, really dangerously irrelevant. Now, the next guy on the list is, he's like an OG. He's kind of the first of many of the Xenoverse characters. And that's right, I'm talking about your boy Demigra. Now, Demigra, I'm not gonna lie to you and tell you that I love this guy, that he got a fucking crazy Cat Williams haircut, and he got like a weird bone staff. Like, he's a freak. He's into some freaky stuff. You see those shoes? Those are some crazy clown shoes. But Demigra came out a long time ago, and he actually was a decent unit because, you know, he's kind of like similar to the Int Turles that was out back in the day, where he has a high chance of stun on his passive, and he has a rare chance of stun on his super. So it'd be kind of cool to see him get, like, an awakening or rebirth, something where, you know, hey, he has a medium chance for the super, and a high chance for the pass or something. Like, give this motherfucker something. Give him some categories, too, bro. I mean, all right, Resurrected Warriors, that's not terrible. But you could do a lot more with this Demigra. And me, personally, someone who's got a crazy haircut like that and got elf ears like that, they deserve more than to just be an asshole from, like, 2016 or 15, whenever the hell he came out. And he's still just a level 80 of 100 shitty UR, not a TUR. Come on, bro. Try to put some respect on this dude's name. Now, next up on the list is one of two pair that kind of came out around the same time, and that would be Int Gohan. Now, Int Gohan is a pretty decent unit. I'd be lying to you if I said that he's amazing. Me, personally, the way I use him, as you can see, I have 14 dodge on this boy. He has a decent chance of basically reducing the damage received by 40%, so he's kind of sort of a tank. And, you know, he's got an okay super attack, raises ally attack plus 20%. He's okay, kind of, sort of. But he could really benefit from a Dokkan Awakening. And Lord knows he's been out for a while. And he is a pretty decent, he has some pretty decent categories, movie heroes, Goku's family. Like, if you got a Dokkan Awakening and they made it where it's, like, guaranteed damage reduction by, like, say, 60%, and he still kept that attack plus 80%, that's pretty respectable. That's a pretty good unit. Like, that's a pretty nice tank. I would put him on the fucking movie heroes team and let him tank Broly's hits. Like, that'd be badass. But, unfortunately for this man, unfortunately for the reality of the situation, he's just a regular UR. He never got his Dokkan Awakening. He never got a rebirth. I'm assuming it would be a Dokkan Awakening, but seeing that he never got an Awakening at all, you never know. I think he could benefit a lot from an Awakening that made him more of a tanky unit, and again, more of a, like, support unit, where either he gets damage reduction up, or he gets some percentage given to the team, something that made him a better ally. But right now, he's just, like, if you're in a pinch, you'll use him, but very rarely do I use him unless I have to. Now, the next one is, again, another card that came out around the same time. That would be the Tech Super Saiyan Trunks. Now, this Tech Trunks, I do use quite regularly, and that is just because he does reduce damage received by 40% when guard is activated. So that basically just means he's kind of like a better version of that old ass R Raditz, where when he's blocking AGL attacks, he actually tanks pretty well. And he did a pretty good job when I used him for, like, Battlefield and things like that, where he's pretty decent. Like, he ain't that bad. Again, if he got an Dokkan Awakening or even a rebirth that made him a little bit more tankier, or, again, his super attack raises Ally's attack by 20%. It'd be cool if he got something where he gives a little bit more to the team, or he has more defense. Him and Goten are pretty much the same card, just different typing, as well as, like, slightly different passive. But I think both could benefit from getting an Awakening, and at the very least, like, make them more tanky or make them more of a support unit. Because right now, there's just, like, a bastardized in the middle of the road, jack of all trades, doing jack shit card. And it's depressing. It's sad to see, especially two units that are pretty good, especially when they first came out. But now the dial of time have made them irrelevant. Now, for the next two I'm about to do, I'm basically going to just package them as a bonus deal, as in they're just in bulk. And now for the next slot, I would put the Extreme Amazing Perfect Cell, the Angel one, as well as the Extreme Tech Amazing Frieza, who's also an Angel. And these guys are kind of, you know, if I had to pick one and say, listen, this motherfucker needs something, I would say Cell, because Cell is just, he's the worst of the two in terms of, like, lengths, in terms of what he does. Attack plus 50% for every key sphere obtained. Oh my god, holy shit. Somebody get a fucking book and write down that this guy's a nuke, or holy moly, guacamole. He's really whatever. Like, he's a very whatever unit, in my opinion. Me, personally, I would think that if he got a Dokkan Awakening, he would need either to get a flat damage up, attack and defense plus 50% plus that, or some way, somehow, he's like a support unit or something. I don't know what you would do with the Cell personally, but he definitely is, like, if I had to say who's worse, I would pick him, because just because of the fact that Cell is always hard to put on the team and have him in a good composition any fucking way, whereas with this Frieza, he's actually pretty good in the sense that, hey, you know what? He has a rare chance to stun, which isn't amazing, but it's better than fucking lowering defense, in my opinion. Attack plus 90%. Okay, that's decent. Definitely, if he got a Dokkan Awakening, I could see if he had attack and defense plus 100%. That wouldn't be the worst thing ever. It'd be okay. I would take that and say, you know what? He's a Frieza unit. He has Universe's Most Malevolent. He has Nightmare. He has all these links. He's going to fit on a team somewhere. he could be a substitute for someone. And, you know, like, just give him an awakening. Like, what is this? What is this day and age where these units, who at the time they were kind of hyped, they were like, all right, it's kind of interesting, Otherworld Arena, you know, seeing these different units come to fruition. But then they just get left behind, and they never get an awakening of any sort whatsoever, and they basically become King of Irrelevance. Now, speaking of King of Irrelevance, I'm going to go ahead, again, I'm going to do a bundle deal. I'm talking about your boy Kuliza, and I'm talking about your guy Weirus. And again, if I had to pick one of the two who I said was worse, I would say Kuliza is worse just because of the fact that he has Transformation Boost, Wicked Bloodline, which is all right. But all he has is attack plus 70% when performing a super attack. That's super fucking low, and that's super fucking ass. His leader skill is dog shit. His super attack has no extra added effect. Again, he is a, you know, kind of like a Frieza category, technically. So, me personally, I think he's a cool card. He looks cool. But, goddamn, bro, like, can you give this man an awakening? Can you give him something to work with? Attack plus 70%? Is it 2017, dude? Give this man some type of fucking bragging rights. This motherfucker got shoulder pads as big as Nappa, a head as big as fucking Cooler, and he has nothing to fucking produce. He has nothing that he brings to the table. Now, Weirus, on the other hand, he actually is used. I see people use him. I do use him. And that's just the simple fact that he is a key changer. And he also gets attack and defense plus 50%, which isn't anything to write home about, but it's better than shitty Kuliza. And he also greatly lowers defense, which, again, it's not anything to write home about, but, you know, when you're talking about Kuliza versus this guy, all of a sudden he's looking real fucking good. His categories are a little ass. It'd be nice if he got Siblings Bond or something similar. I'd also say that if he ever got an awakening, it'd be nice to see him get maybe some type of, like, I don't know, like, either he changes an extra key sphere and he gets, like, a defense, attack and defense plus 70% to 90%, or you give him something that's a little bit more of a support role, because that's what you're using for anyway, it's just kind of like a support character. But it'd be nice to see him get a Doke on Awakening. It'd be nice to see him have Fierce Battle, or, you know, even Shattering the Limit. You know, just something. Give him something, dude. Like, he's been out for a while. People like him. I do like him. There's obviously a bunch of other Dragon Ball Fusions characters, and even some people would argue Dragon Ball Heroes characters that need awakenings. But for me personally, I'd say Kuliza and Weirus are at the top of the list. Now, here comes the top three. These three are, for me, these are the ones that I think of when I say, God damn, that character needs an awakening. And these three are probably the most disrespectful, forgotten characters, just because of the fact that they're OGs, they've been around for a while. They basically paved the way for everything that's in this game, and if they weren't here low-key, it wouldn't be the same. So let's go ahead and say it. Number three, that big head, that metal dildo, metal rildo. Dude's been out for a hot minute. He used to be a pretty decent tank. Defense plus 10,000 at start of turn. Okay, he ain't a tank anymore. He's just ass at this point. It'd be great to see him get a Dokkan Awakening and say, you know what, defense plus, let's just say 50,000, okay, that's not great, I don't think that's great at all, but give him, like, defense plus 50,000, and maybe attack and defense plus 50%, something, make him, like, holy shit, look at this guy, he's, like, fucking Piccolo, he has so much defense, oh my god, and right now he has, because of supreme damage and lowers attack, kind of, sort of, okay, I mean, lowers attack is nice, but this, dude, and he's only in one category, artificial life forms, I definitely think he could be in, like, I don't fucking know, artificial life forms, creepy niggas category, something, give him something, like, he's out here, he's got the big ass head, he looks like a retarded version of, like, Shaquille O'Neal, and he's been around in the game for a while, dude, like, just give him an awakening, and now, the next one is something that hurts, it's near and dear to my heart, and it'd be amazing if he got a Dokkan Awakening, and that would be Super Saiyan 2 Trunks. This guy is the definition of a forgotten card because he's actually really cool. He's actually pretty useful. He was always used as a support character, STR type attack and defense plus 25%, raises attack for 3 turns on super. He's in like 4 categories, which is, you know, for some reason they decided to update him with Bond and Master Disciple, like people are going to use him, but I digress. I think this Trunks could be way better and he could do way more if people just gave him more support. Make him, you know, STR type attack and defense plus 40%, or make it a little bit more general, make it a category, make it a Vegeta family category, anything, just give him something, and maybe just give him supreme damage and raise his attack for 6 turns or 9 turns or something that stacks, and just give him something to fucking live for, give him something that he deserves. He's been in the game for like a millennia, and he really has nothing other than, if you're just starting off the game and you need some type of a support for STR type, he literally is a forgotten card. And dude, he's one of the cooler cards. Like, his card art is amazing. Like, he's got the fresh cut, he's got the beautiful art, he's got the beautiful background, but he has like an ass passive of subpar super and barely any categories. Like, can this motherfucker get something going? Like, Jesus Christ, dude. Like, what did he do wrong? He ain't even... Hold up. What? He ain't even in the Future Saga category? What the fuck? Okay. Alright. So there you go. That's like the top, you know, 9 so far. I did a couple bundle deals. I did a couple bulk deals. I just have to say, before I continue to number 1, I just gotta give you one honorable mention. I usually don't do this. I'll usually be like, oh, whatever, you know, top 10, blah, blah, blah. But I just got to say, I know I already made a video about this, but Tech Final Form Frieza. Technically, he has a Dokkan Awakening. Technically, he Dokkan Awakens into a shittier card where he gets, oh my god, supreme damage to enemy, attack plus 40%. Holy shit. Tech Final Form Frieza is like, this is the one card that I wished got a decent Dokkan Awakening. There's not that many Final Form Friezas in the game. There, other than the AGL one, everyone else is like free to play. You don't know how happy I'd be if this guy just got base attack and defense plus 120%, and then maybe gave him a super that does something. I would be so happy. Let me just say, this Tech Final Form Frieza, I already made a video about how ass he is and how to make the best of him, but I had to mention him, because when I think about cards that should have gotten a Dokkan Awakening earlier, or at the very least a decent Awakening, I think of that Frieza and I cry on inside. But I digress. Honorable mention. Just wanted to say that Tech Final Form Frieza, it's fucking depressing the state that he's in. Now, number 1. This is the one card that I don't understand did not get a Dokkan Awakening yet, and that would be Super Saiyan Goku. Now, if you play this game, this was the card to get when you first started playing. There was Super Saiyan Goku, Super Saiyan Vegeta. There was also the shitty Tech Vegeta and the shitty AGL Goku. But this was the card, dude. He was the only card at the beginning of the game that I remember having attack plus 50% when Ki is 5 or more. Now, that's a big deal, dude. Ki plus 5, first of all, back in the day, you weren't guaranteed to get that. You didn't have Ki leaders, right? And attack plus 50%, as you saw with that Frieza, attack plus 30% was considered to be decent. Whereas this guy is attack plus 50%. And now, this SSR is so old that he actually causes extreme damage to enemy. And as you may or may not know, this is like a step above huge damage, aka shit damage. So, my man has like no links. He has 1, 2, 3, 4. He has 4 links, dude. Give this man something to fucking fight for. Give him prepare for battle. This man got the gi on. This man has been preparing. Give him prepare for battle. Like, this guy literally, I would love if he got a Dokkan Awakening and got like real good treatment. Like, if he got, you know, let's just say something crazy, something I would live for. Attack and defense plus 130% when Ki is 5 or more. Maybe give him something on the super where he builds defense for 3 turns or something. Anything. Just give him something that he deserves for being in the game from day 1. This is a card that you look forward to. You'd be like, oh my god. If I ever pulled this card when I first started playing this game, I would have been ecstatic. I was lucky to get in Gohan, but if I got this STR Goku, I'd be shitting my pants. Unfortunately, as time has gone on, this guy technically is not in the banner anymore. You cannot even pull him. Same goes for that Tech Final Form Frieza. So it's highly unlikely that anytime soon he's going to get a Dokkan Awakening or Rebirth or anything, because you can't even pull him at this point. He's been literally just retired. But you know what? I still respect the man. He's still got that God tier art. He's still got the Fist of the North Star. He's still got that fresh cut. And this is like the epitome of this game. Like, this Goku was the poster child for playing this game. And the fact that he doesn't have an Awakening or even a Rebirth or something. At this point, this motherfucker should have had a Dokkan Awakening 2 years ago. And we should be talking about how amazing his EZA is. He really got the short end of the stick. But at the end of the day, that's about it. Those are the top 10 units. Or, you know, some of those were lumped in with each other just because it was a nice bonus deal. But for me, personally, game's been around for 5 years. It's about high time that some reparations were paid out. Go ahead and give Goku the fucking Dokkan Awakening. After that, give it to Super Saiyan Trunks. After that, give it to that stupid Metal Dildo Metal Rildo. And then everyone else could be a free-for-all, but at some point they should get an Awakening. But come on, Akatsuki. Like, come on. You got to stop taking all your time and focus on catching Jinjuriki and shit, and try to focus on giving these cards that have been out for fucking 5 years, some of them, some three, four, give them an awakening. Because at this point, I'm looking at these cards, and I'm just thinking to myself, why do they exist? Why are you in my box? I mean, granted, they look cool, they're nice, but they ain't doing shit. They ain't pulling their weight. They're about to really get put on fucking life alert and have life support pumped into their system. But at the end of the day, there's not much to say. I would love to see these cards get a Dokkan Awakening. But I think that is pretty much it. Like I said before, there's some other top 10 videos. I made a playlist. And in the future, I'll try to do this a little bit closer together. I know this has been like, what, 6 months or some shit. But, you know, it takes time. Especially something like this. It's just something this salty. I had to take 2 water pills and drink like a gallon of water just to fucking say what I just said. But hey, at the end of the day, at least one thing is for certain, these cards are probably never going to get an awakening.